The current and modern nuclear power plants are usually based on large-size reactors. Is it a sort of universal law, or can a small-size nuclear reactor possibly designed and built in a modular way be a viable option, or even a competitor in the energy market? I am Sara Boarin and I will guide your initial steps into the intriguing world of the small modular reactors. First of all, what is a small modular reactor? We can define an SMR as a nuclear reactor of small size. Usually the power is less than 300 megawatt electric, whatever coolant technology has been adopted. It may have a design consisting of modules that are typically manufactured in shops and transported to and assembled on site. The dimensions of the reactor, the containment building and the site are smaller compared to the large reactors. Nowadays, the interest in this type of technology is growing. Let's understand why. First, we must consider that SMRs are not the current standard represented by large reactors. The historical trend is very clear. At the beginning of the nuclear energy era, small-size reactors were the standard, but by 1980, the power and consequently the size of the reactors has increased. The main reason is the well-known economy of scale law. Usually, in the industrial sector, we experience that increasing the size and capacity of a plant is better, because the costs increase less than the size and capacity, thus saving money and time. That means we are reducing the specific cost when increasing the size. In terms of overall costs, the ratio between the cost of a plant with respect to the cost of a reference size plant goes with the ratio of the power size to the power of alpha, with alpha typically in a range between 0.6 and 0.8. So, if this is the trend, why should a small reactor be of interest? There are both specific reasons and potential reasons. In some cases, the larger reactors are simply not suitable. For example, because the electrical grid of a country is not developed enough to sustain a large concentrated power production, which could lead to stability risk, or because there is a limited availability of flowing cooling water. Also, the goal could be to supply energy to remote areas where large site infrastructure can hardly be built, or simply because the utility does not have the financial strength to sustain a huge investment of tens of billions of euro or dollars. But there are also more specific arguments for choosing the small modular reactor option over the large reactor. It can be a design simplification that is implemented, allowing cost reduction and innovative safety features. There are usually based on passive safety systems, and the construction time can be reduced, which reduces the overall cost as well, leading to financial risk limitation. Or smaller size entails that it is possible to build and assemble modules in a shop instead of on-site. And the staggered deployment of the SMRs, that means the construction of multiple modules one after the other, allows for the self-financing of the construction of subsequent modules. We could identify a sort of economy of multiples for the SMR technology, counterbalancing or at least reducing the economy of scale penalization caused by the small size. Starting from the specific cost of a large reactor, if we want to deploy an SMR-based power station with the same capacity, for example, 4 SMR modules versus 1 large, the specific cost of one single SMR module, same type of the large reactor, increases due to the loss of economy of scale. But a set of positive SMR features can reduce that penalization. First, multiple small modular units on the same site can share some infrastructures and services. Second, the typical learning process during construction is accelerated for the SMRs, since several modules are built. This means time and cost reduction. This also happens with the modularization of components, systems and plants, which allows shop construction, series production, together with quality increase. And the staggered deployment allows for scalability of the investment, for example, according to energy demand, and together with a shorter construction time and payback time, leads to reduction of the financial cost and risk. The last SMR feature is not just a small replica of the larger reactors, but different solutions and layouts could be applied, potentially involving a relevant simplification leading to cost reduction. At the end of this set of consideration, the cost penalization between SMR and large reactor could still exist, but it is reduced to the original economy of scale gap. As a final comment, what we addressed in this first part of the lecture are the main economic features about the SMR concept.